Hello and welcome back. My name is Matt Letter, and today we're going to continue our Pillars of Eternity Let's Play series. We are currently exploring the first level of the Endless Paths of Ord Nuar. We'll have to see where it takes us, and we want to quickly take a look out here. And we already find a trap.
Time to see and not be seen.
Trap disarmed. And there's a Sorup again. Yeah, he's not long for this world. Salute him.
I shall be discreet.
Stealth mode and look what's out here. Bunch of silver. Let's check out this room then. Another trap detected.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Let them come.
Rave down.
This is a perfect opportunity for some area of effect.
Yes.
I rarely get to use it. Oh wow, that's awesome. I love it when they line up like that. But man, are they doing some damage here. He depopulated them. Not bad.
Let's go.
More go down. And you four. No, go down here.
Yes.
You as well.
Hey.
Nope. Down here, please, all of you.
Yeah.
Don't run straight into the trap. And kill the worm. And now the skirmisher. You get to attack as well. You go ahead and disarm.
That's settled.
Wonderful.
Huh?
That was Aloth's combat, quite literally. He tore them apart. Okay, what do they have? More of the usual.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea. Which
here
is
we have Silverlusk.
Not very quiet.
Ah, the entry is trapped.
The flame has shown us.
A bunch more interesting stuff. Nothing major though. Let's disarm. And inside we have a broken blade. Huh. Ooh. The blade of the endless paths. A great and ancient weapon has been dismantled, its pieces strewn throughout the endless paths of Ord Nuar. Perhaps if all the pieces can be found again, the weapon can be reforged. Cool. So, something to look forward to for later. I guess a lot later though. Let's speed up and exit sneak mode. And let's see what kind of enemy we'll face here. We'll do a quick save though.
Hello.
And then we start sneaking again.
Hello.
Stepping into this chamber, you're assailed by a cacophony of screeches, growls, and barks. Blood-spattered Sorup stands in frantic, leaping motions. To one side, a Sorup plunges his hands into a bucket teeming with blood, to daub patterns onto others eager to join the rites. At the far end of the room, one Sorup, wearing the long skull of a young drake and vibrant feathers, shakes a staff towards the gathered Sorup, screeching and clicking. The High Priest suddenly raises the staff above his head, shrieking with renewed vigor. He swings the staff downward to point it at the pit, and then at you. I am not sure I like that suggestion, says Aloth. Yeah, neither do I. Let's retreat for a moment. What was that about? We'll fight them here in the gate. Switch your song to some damaging stuff. You go in as well to have some fun. We'll need to take some care of our main character this time around though. He's quite low. And the High Priest deigned to come out. That I like because that means you're gonna get a necrotic lance straight to the face. Pillar of Faith. I wanna try it out. Bam! There goes the High Priest. At least one of the two. I think it was two. Actually, it was only one High Priest. There we go. Some enemies taken care of. Let's see if we can sneak in and chuck some magic at another priest.
Lava beyond sea.
And go out again. Thank you for participating. That worked out nicely. Go ahead and stun them all. You can go back in. Yeah, these Sorab aren't exactly a big problem. Like, not at all. Everyone's still attacking, good. We'll go here.
Let's go.
Easy. Nice. Turn back. There's only death upon the endless paths. We'll have to talk with you in a moment. We can't. So they warned us not to go deeper. Maybe for good reason. We shall find out. Oh, there's something down here actually still. Oil and gold.
I shall be quiet as a
gold is ever
sea,
welcome.
Which
fine
is
leather armor.
Not very quiet.
And some stuff to look at up here. This bucket is filled with blood and gives off an acrid stench. He recognizes it Mokar's tears. A powerful poison. The blood spilled from this bucket seems to have eaten into the stone. Come on. There, sorry. The rope tied to the bucket looks long enough to descend into the pit. Ha!
Something over
found
there.
Something secret. A measured restraint. A particularly interesting rapier, perhaps. I think... No, not Kana. Who was it that used rapiers? Aloth. We'll give it to him. So... Heresy and plus enemies engaged. Not the best for Aloth, but yeah. It's not like we'll use him in melee at all. Okay, what's here? This white pit descends into a grim darkness. You hear the whistling howl of wind, and from time to time, hot gusts of air tug at your clothing. Before I do anything, let's quick save. So, we can use a grappling hook to descend, jump into it, try to climb down the side of the pit, or examine it. Let's examine it first. The chasm appears to have been dug out with tools rather than being a natural formation. It seems to be very deep, but you cannot see the bottom to gauge the distance. Grappling hook. You take the grappling hook from your pack and tie it off neatly around one of the heavy stone blocks surrounding the pit. A few hard tugs suggest that the rope will hold fast. Keeping a firm hold on the rope, you begin to descend, your descent into the darkness. Soon the edge of the pit is far above your head, and you can only hear the creak of the rope and your own breaths. Soon enough, however, you see another source of light, far below. Past the dangling end of the rope, you can see a dimly lit room, at the center of which is a circular stone pool. The pool is filled with blood, and even at the distance you can pick out various limbs and mangled bodies, largely sorib in nature. The tunnel bored into the stone ends a ways above the chamber below, and your rope extends no further. Let's be ballsy and jump into the pool of blood. Bracing yourself for the landing, you loosen your hold, dropping down the remaining distance to land within the pool of blood with a noisy splash. The thick, murky waters hinder your swimming, threaten to pull you down into the unseen depths of this grim pit. But at last, you crest the surface and pull yourself up and over the brim. You find yourself at the edge of a reeking, sludgy mixture of blood and limbs. Let's see where that took us. Does it tell us? Whoa! Endless paths of a new level 5. Are you shitting me? Holy damn. I'm not sure I want to be here. Like, at all.
I shall be discreet.
Let's stealth around. Want and a whole lot of money.
My eyes are peeled.
And here we have an expedition log page. Where is it? Here. This appears to be a page torn from some larger text. Saya didn't make it. I know Merrick tried his best. No point in turning back now. That's what Merrick is saying. I think the point is leaving these ruins alive. We have lost half of our people already, and I am not sure how we are meant to survive this place, especially with Skaya gone. The gods were kind to let us find that study and the books there. Those tomes would fetch a good price in and of themselves. We don't need to go any further. But that seal has stirred his blood. He's sure we'll find more Angwithin relics below. Every step takes us further from a guaranteed haul and deeper into unknown territory. I don't know what madness has gripped him. I cannot stop thinking about Edriga, the way she screamed. So, ooh. Plenty of traps. Let's disarm them. Sorry, champions. Let's see what's out here. I don't think we can go up again. Whoa, a drake! At the edge of this expansive chamber, encircled by a gibbering host of saurops, stands a massive reptilian creature. Its snout is spattered with the bloody remnants of a recent meal, gobbets of flesh still spared on crooked fangs. The saurops shift anxiously, looking up expectantly at the drake as the beast stretches leathery wings in a challenge, brushing the pillars to either side. Yes, yes, more sacrifice! It flaps its wings, briefly, and stirs up a great cloud of dust. Come here, human, be honored.
You speak?
The drake stamps one clawed foot upon the ground. I speak, and stone shakes. I speak, and the lizards bring gold. I speak, and eat well. Yes, I speak.
Let me pass, and I'll do you no harm.
What? Sacrifice cannot leave. You think you see a section of the drake's scaled chest begin to glow orange as it laws. Sacrifice is not very smart. Flames gout from its nostril and gaping jaws. Master made me lord. Here. Here I am king. I am god of fire and gold.
Yeah. Just saying, a little wager, I think we're gonna need to reload that one. But let's try. No knowing until you've done it, you know? So. Let's give us a zone of shelter. For however long we remain alive, that is. From what I see, not very long, holy. Yeah, this isn't going well.
Yes.
Let's move in closer. Increase the heal. Stun everyone. Necrotic lands on the drake. And we may still be able to do this, actually. Let's spread some doubt.
That's not very
helpful. Another necrotic lens, please. Kana. Reduce damage reduction, please. Probably not gonna work, but you can try. Oh, we actually interrupted him. My bad. Let's get skeletons instead. This is not easy. Let's knock down the Saurop champion if we can. Circle of healing on the ground, please. Okay, those skeletons came out and died. And Kana died, like, proper, apparently. Come on, take revenge upon the creature.
Yes.
Even if I die, I won't go down easy.
Let's burn this away! Don't even swing it down!
Yes.
Nothing much we can do, really. Just keep having... keep hitting at it and see where it takes us. Let's see if we can terrorize it. It's immune. Who would have thought? Okay, what else to do? Okay, we don't need concentration will. Let's go for the divine mark. Yeah, we did it. Holy balls, we did it.
Yes?
That was unexpected. Not that I think it will do us all too much good, because I'm still not seeing a way to get up again. At least not yet. Ilfen Bringar Solos, an amulet of health. Let's check the amulet. Maximum endurance bonus. This only gives us a little bit of things, so let's go with that. Kana. Only gives you only little as well. What about you? Everyone already has these protection things everywhere. Okay, then something to sell, perhaps. So, 16 deflection, minus 8 accuracy. And this is plus 50 defense while stunned and prone. And plus 8 shield deflection. Oh yeah. We want that thing. On Edder. Okay, I'm definitely going to save here, a hard save. If I can at all, I would like to actually get out of here with my good loot, and I'll try to camp here. Okay, just rest.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to sneak up on you. I just... Well, you seemed preoccupied.
You've just begun to stretch and soothe the aches from your body when you feel Alath over your shoulder. He looks away quickly when you notice him, kneading his hands into squirming fists. You seem preoccupied.
Mad old watchers, a cult on our trail? What's not to worry about?
True.
I suppose I've just noticed you acting a little, unusual lately. Talking to people who aren't there, remembering flashbacks of your previous life. I just want to make sure you're doing all right.
He stares at a spot on the ground, and with enough perception, this is really about.
I was just checking in on you. That's all. I should let you rest. It looks like we'll have another full day tomorrow.
If we survive. Okay, so something's up with Aloth. Okay, the vague shapes of Kith are visible in the cold black ash coating the brickwork. Where does that lead us here? Deeper down? I'm anxious to see. We are... Nope, in level 6. Let's get out of here. Oh, man, that was one exciting combat. A fucking drake. Holy shit, I really wouldn't have guessed we'd be able to take it down.
Quiet.
Utter madness. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's position our people properly.
Following your lead.
Yeah.
And then let's see if we can't chuck in a spell, perhaps. Yeah, we can't, at least not easily.
Huh?
Damn. That didn't work out. I wanted him to run back right away. Let's knock everyone down if we can. Damn, he's down. Okay, Kana, there's not enough space. You switch to your gun. And out here we're going with a blessing.
Following your lead. Moe.
Shoot at the high priest. How much damage does this actually do? Not a little. Okay. Debuff them all. There we go. Attack the high priest as well. Okay, Eder's right up front. I can't withdraw him. I need to give her a bow. I really need to.
Eh?
This isn't working out as it should. Okay, you have enough, so let's get some skeletons up in here. We don't need healing outside of one character who's down already. And so far it's actually going okay.
We're down one!
Yeah, the skeletons are down already. I feared that would happen quickly.
Yeah.
But he already has another bunch ready, but first we'll do a damage reduction shout. Should make it easier for us to break through and get to the actual High Priest. Priest needs a bit more attack somehow. But well, I guess I'm limited to just fling from distance. And in this combat, actually, Kana's damage over time ability actually does pretty good work. And now we need the heals.
Following you.
More skeletons, please. Okay, we're about to break through, yeah. Take your second wind, everyone. Kana, you keep shooting at the High Priest. The priest is down. The primary challenge is thus already solved.
Let's see what lies this way.
Okay. Garnets, a whole bunch of other stuff. If we manage to get out here, we'll be rich. Major regeneration potion. And a whole lot more money.
And the fire shows me something new.
And something hidden. Oh, quick save.
Right.
The Sorabs have piled together coins, discarded jewelry, and battered fragments of ornamental weapons and armor. Let's see. Money? Then a fine large shield, and this is a final mace. Stuff to sell. And down here, more money and the ornate sword hilt. Awesome.
Let's go, let's go!
Oh, retreat, retreat. Or don't retreat, you know. Who needs retreating? That was a massively good move by the AI, actually. Let's tackle the priest first thing. We go with a blessing.
Then we go with the interdiction.
Yeah.
Now that Eloth is no longer limited down. Ooh, fuck, another high priest. Okay. These combats are really freaking challenging. Kill the base priest first. Okay, I really, really need the big spells here, I think. Okay, the Sora priest is down. That's good to hear. Let's instead retarget to the high priest. Kana is ready, so let's shout all the damage reduction down. Attack the high priest as well. Durance. instill doubt. There's a lot of enemies where it should hit. And Adair destroyed his target. Let's retarget him to the champion. We got a bunch of upgrades, a bunch of experience for getting the Sora Priest entry. Eloth taking a bunch of damage. Let's take Bounding Missiles. You use your Holy Radiance. Oh, the Big Priest is down as well, good. We're making headway. Kana, give me skeletons. Following your lead. Just to flank them. Things are going better than expected, really. We'll have to see how long we can keep this up. At some point the spells will run dry, as will the camp materials. We have two people down here that do nothing, so you get to attack the champion. You as well, please.
Following your lead.
Everyone attack the champion.
I'm not going anywhere like this.
Oh, I accidentally gave it to Aleth. Eh, no matter. If we make it alive out here, I'll have to do a whole reorganization between episodes.
My eyes are peeled.
Camp materials! That's coming massively in handy. This is exciting, but for now I'll have to call it off. Oh, there's up. I will have to explore that the next time. So yeah, thank you all for watching. This episode was massively exciting. We suddenly jumped down to the fifth level of the Endless Paths, and so far are doing actually pretty good. Let's see how long we can keep it up, if we can keep it up. I thank you all for watching, I hope you had some fun. If you did, consider commenting, liking, or subscribing. You can also follow me on Twitter at @_madlatterer. And that's it from me for this episode. See you the next time. Bye.